wa sono bina lo bana lo po tuning ba lo baka là où je vis au Canada les gens parlent l'anglais c'est l'anglophone et place on a fan daka wa ba lo baka anglais ça anglophone ça francophonie alors na ko lo ba mingi na anglais français oui muke lingala mo muke kuna OK so bito yena biso awa moni na na nini ngai patu oyo guys I have to be honest with you okay I have to be honest with you you know several years ago something happened to me that thing caused a lot of problem to me it happened here in Canada it has something to do with the system in Canada right so when I met my ex back in the day the girl is a good person she's really good I give her a lot of credit and then I have a lot of respect for her but the system we have in Canada is it's good I don't the system is great but the corruption make the system make the way I can put it the system makes the Canadian politician and leader to me to look like worse leaders because of the system you see so when I met my ex back in the day we have a system here in Canada we call this it's a child welfare when you fight you beat your wife something happened they're gonna come to protect the kid okay I don't blame them what they do is good but the corruption destroy the system you see So that time when I involved that problem, because the mother of my kid, she has a problem with them in the past. It has nothing to do with me. But I have a special the course I'm going to teach you guys about that, okay? Please take your time and then watch that carefully because a lot of people fell in Canada. A lot of people blame me in the past. They say, no, you beat your girlfriend, this. I'm like, no, I'm an innocent man. They say, how? Until when I show them the evidence, they say, oh, my God, forgive us. I'm like, I understand. It's the system. You don't understand the system, right? That's why you can talk. You know, like when Job, Satan came, attacked him. But people don't understand that. Satan attacking Job on something that Job didn't do anything bad to Satan, right? Like a lot of people blaming him, similar to me. But to me, the way I analyze and to understand this situation because of these people I put here. You see, Bruce Lee, I didn't know him a lot when I was a little. But I ended up knowing him later on, right? So what happened? When I watched this movie, there's a part you're going to see Bruce Lee when the opponent, that guy was attacking him. The guy was in the mirror. When he hit him, he ran away in the mirror, right? Bruce Lee couldn't see him. So what happened when Bruce Lee destroyed the mirror and then he ended up seeing the enemy? So same thing with me in my case, right? So what happened to me? I start fighting with the mirror, but I cannot see the enemy. In that case, the mirror represents the women I date. Not all the women are bad. No, the women are good. But the system destroys the women. If a woman don't, I mean the women in a plural form, they don't have education. You see? So to me, I stopped dating. I focus on school. And that's why I ended up realizing that, oh, it's a system. It's a woman blind me to destroy the system. But not all the women can blind me, no. There's a great woman there, so we cannot blame the other one. We have to find the problem and solve it. So I learned a lot of stuff from Bruce Lee. Ho Chi Minh, this guy's from Vietnam, I learned a lot from him. A lot. To make me understand that. Why we have a lot of problem in Africa. Why can't we get out to become successful? I learned a lot from him. And him a lot. Joseph Stalin, I learned a lot from him. He has a great, amazing leadership and management. Patrice Lumumba, I learned a lot from him. Joseph Kasa-Vubu, I learned a lot from him, how to be humble, calm down, control the problem. Steve Jobs, I learned a lot from him. Bill Gates, I learned a lot from him. Some of the people, don't, because there are a lot of them, right? And then I cannot name all of them, but I learned a lot from Michael Jordan. I learned a lot from him. I learned a lot from Oprah. I learned a lot from Dr. Dre. I learned a lot also how to be calm and control the situation from Snoop Dogg. You see, I learned a lot from Jay-Z. I learned a lot from Nas. I learned a lot from Eminem. I learned a lot from my mom and my dad. I also learned a lot from my sister. I learned a lot. Every day, like, I understand a lot of stuff because of my sister. Because my sister taught me a lot of things about life compared to my brother. I didn't learn a lot. From my brother, I learned a lot about French. My brother, he's my back home there. But real life, how to deal with the situation, I learned that from my sister, my older sister. I learned from her. She's the one who helped me a lot to understand. So we come here. There's one on the theologian says that love is listening. Yes. When you guys watch my video, I was talking about the R of listening. This theologian, his name is Paul. Paul says love is listening, right? It's really important to listen. Really, really important. You have to learn how to listen to people. If you don't listen, you know, when you're in a relationship, your boyfriend don't listen to you, your girlfriend don't listen to you, your husband don't listen to you, your fiance don't listen to you, you guys are gonna fail. We come here. That's what I put. Listening, love, caring, and a relationship are closely related. Listening, love, caring, and a relationship are the central of the helping process. You know, when you are a counselor, you're helping somebody have a problem, you have to listen. You know, when you go for a job interview, they listen to you when they ask you some question. Even when you go to your family doctor, he has to listen. When he listens to you, he's going to understand your problem well. Okay? Listening is important. I'm going to explain to you guys why 90% of African men, women, kids fail. The one they live in Africa, the same one who live in North America. I'm not talking about African American. No. I'm talking about the African who move here as an international student or refugee. Why we fail. But we're going to solve this problem, okay? Same thing with some of the white. We're going to solve this problem here today, okay? We're not going to solve everything, but to provide you guys the tool you guys need, okay? We come here. We call this the micro skills, okay? So you may say, how are you teaching this? Like I said before, I mastered this in college. Because I've been in a situation, I explain to everyone I know, they blame me. They say, no, you did this, you did this, you did not. But people who understand me well and help me a lot is Chinese. When I explain to Chinese about my situation, no, I started with Congolese who live in Canada. I explained to them, no, they didn't understand. They blame me a lot. I'm like, oh my God, what am I going to do with this? I went to see a Congolese guy. I think by now he's like 62 years old. way back in the day. He was like careless about it. He didn't care about it. I met him like a few times. He didn't care. So I went to see different person. He worked for the government. The government paid him, but I didn't really get help from him. Based on my kid that time when I faced the problem. And I went to see, I went to the African community. I remember when I went there, they blamed me too. They said, oh no, you beat your girlfriend, you did this. I say, no, I didn't do that. When I showed them the evidence, they say, okay. I remember that it wasn't Sunday when I went to that place. I'm like, what am I going to do now? Because everybody I'm going to not understand the situation I face. So I went to the African, they didn't understand it. African community, they didn't get it. They didn't understand that. I went to, that time, I didn't meet Congolese, no. I went to the Congolese man to talk to him. He's like, I think like 62 or 63 years old. I didn't get any help from him. Like he didn't like care about it. From my life experience, that's what I'm explaining to you guys. So, African community. Na kutena bango, oh mama, bando blaminga. Yo beta mwasi na yo, boye. Ah, na ebe kutuswe lo na salate. Na eba meme kamarani mo na doza ani, tondo ya ndeko na amu kwa mwasi msusowa. Ye kubutususu, mama. Mwonsu kundo sana problem mo kwa makasi, o esplike ngo batu. Batu msuba bando kima yo. Ba mwona lokula yo za problematiki. Po bazo comprendre te. Yangomonique, listening is important. Bazo comprendre te. Po na communauté na biso to jijaka mingi ke olie ke to fanda to analyse te zwa solution. Biso zwa la solution te. Ba problème oko ekwelanga batu oba edenga makasi za ba chinois. Tango na solution na ba chinois ba bisinga tala moni yo to tangi na to yebi yo. Loko yo sali yango te. La lakisi bamba doki mamba wabi oui, to yebi. A partir ona yona yako yeba ke, ba chinois, ba japonais, ba coréen. Na ba tu a reçu, ba zama yele kole kabiso ba kongole. Yango zomo na, guerre o eza na kongese koko sila te, po, eza koutu kesu moko, biso kaka ndengi to zali, ndengi to rezonaka, eza normal te. Ngana yeba kongole, bele te ona explike ba makambo, papa, yo de poko tena ko poto, kaka boye, kasi mita zana problem, so ke o zana maladi. Ok, pa docteur ba soanyan o tenge zamo, ke e longa mbang. Men so ko zi mkute na docteur, bala moko te, e banda ko vimba mone o yoko kufa. Alors, e koma yana problem o na system o to zana ngo, so ba boto liyo bana la police, zana kati. Yangono mouni fubota la bakou na msuzo na koma ya krimno, Canadian criminal justice system, you understand? Chikono ba no tanks ba kure bele, bono mona. Alors, biso ba kongole to zana ba problem, mena olo bela ngon apre. So, that's what I put here, listening, okay? The basics, listening, thank you, the basics, listening. You need to attending an empathy skill, you need that. Observation skill, you need it. The question, okay? You need to encourage paraphrasing and summarizing, okay? You need to, so this is how I put like five of them. There's a lot of them, but this is how I break them down, okay? Guys, some of you may say that, oh, how do you speak like this? Because, you know, English is not my first language. Sometimes I explain to, I go slowly for the other people to understand, okay? In this case, if you want to become a counselor, you want to help the other people, this course is good for you. Okay? It's really important. It's really good. It's going to help you a lot. You need to have this skill. Okay? So, we have empathy, relationship, That's what I put, five stage of the counseling session, okay? Empathy, relationship, story, strength, goal, story, action, okay? These are the five part of the counseling session, okay? We come here to influencing client action and decision, focusing, empathy, confrontation, reflection of the meaning and interpretation, okay? Stress management, okay? So, you need, when you're facing a lot of problem, you're gonna be stressed, you're gonna get angry. You know, something I learned in my life, when you didn't do anything wrong to the situation you are facing, it's easy to become much angrier. You know, when you didn't do anything wrong, when they keep blaming you, they blame you, you're gonna be angry to death, really angry. But if you did it, and you know you did that thing is wrong, you're not gonna be that much angry. No, you're not. There's a difference. When you go see a lot of counselors, they don't get it. Many of them don't. I'm gonna tell you why. When the corruption is mixed in the system, those social worker, counselor, they don't care anymore. When I went to see those counselor back in the day, in my case, they want my kid, so they didn't really focus on me. So I used to watch them carefully because I have the tool for my back home. What I got for my sister, my mom, my friends, it helped me a lot in Canada. But the social worker, they didn't understand me that I was watching them carefully. Really carefully, because the way it works in Canada, you have to be careful. If you're not careful, well, you're gonna become a mental illness. It's easy. A lot of stuff I learned here. If you wanna talk to me privately, please, at the end of the video, you can see my email. Email me or phone me. We can go on Zoom privately. I can provide you guys a lot. If you have you need help, I can help you, because the time I faced this problem, I didn't know the system until I went to school to study this, okay? It's easy to become mental illness, stress, angriness, and some of your friends, they may stay away from you. They think like you are a problem. But I have a great friend. I don't want to name his name here. He's an amazing guy. He's amazing. A lot of people, you know, Jamaican understand the problem a lot of people facing in Canada. I have a lot of respect for Jamaican. I have a lot of respect for Chinese. I have a lot of respect for Japanese. I have a lot of respect for Korean. A lot of respect. And Russian. They understand. When you have a problem, people can calm you down and help you a lot. It's Jamaican. I'm Jamaican men. I never deal with the Jamaican women, but men. Some people will say, oh, Jamaican men, no. A lot of Jamaican men understand Canadian well and they understand the system. So most of my problem, like when I used to talk to my, when I talk to my friends, this, my friends help me a lot. You know, it doesn't have to be money, but mentally, like emotionally, they help me a lot. That's why that time I'm like, good thing I have my friend. Even the Muslim help you a lot, a lot. The Christian, oh boy. They blame, like some, like to me, like my recommendation when you have a problem, email me, call me, I will talk to you, I will help you. When you go in a Congolese community, you're not going to get help, you're not. When you go to the different organization we have here in Ontario, you're not going to get help at all. You're not going to get help. I'm going to tell you guys why. When I faced this problem many years ago for my kid, right? What happened? They sent me to go see a counselor. I went there. In reality, I'm not supposed to see a counselor. Because what happened that time, the problem I had, it was based on the mother of my kid, not me. Because she's the one that had the problem with the system. It has nothing to do with you guys. If I lied to you guys about this, God kill me. It has nothing to do with me. So, she was in the system, she was being raised on the system. So when we have our kid, it's a long story. I have to prepare the video for you guys to hear that part. Okay, it's gonna take forever if I explain to you guys this, okay? I'm just gonna close it. But the day I'm gonna explain to you guys this, you guys can understand what kind of life I had. It was tough. I have to deal with the police. I have to deal with the social worker. I have to deal with so many people, like more than 500 people I'm dealing with myself alone. But I had a friend who understands me well, the Jamaican, Chinese, Japanese, Korean, and Russian. That's why what I learned is I figured that if I have a different course, I'm going to explain to you about relation, about who you can date, the great women to date in North America to have a kid. I'm going to teach you guys in different courses, okay? So, this is what I put here. When you're facing that problem, you are stressed, you are angry. If I come back where I was when I was telling, what I was saying about when they sent me to go see a counselor, this is what happened. I went there. That was in 2010. I'm not supposed to go see a counselor. No. They just told me, you know, you have to go see a counselor, this. I said to myself, why? It's the system forcing you to do it. If you are innocent or not, you're not innocent, you're going to feel guilty on something you didn't do. I'm like, oh, my, that's not good. So I went there and then I started a program. It's like for angriness or something like that. And then after that, I remember when I started that program, I also was a student. I was going to, I went to different college, the public college. That time I started my computer system technology. No, I started software engineer, my first year. When our first child born, after a week, the problem started. That problem destroyed my class. It was terrible. And then when I started going to that program, I remember the social worker who was teaching them. Oh man, not good. You're not allowed to. She's talking to people like you're a little kid. I look at myself and say, what? Because where I grew up and I live, no, you don't talk to people like that. You talk to people like low class. So sometimes the way she's doing it to make you really angry, but to me as a Christian, the way I look at it, that's not the way to help people. She's a social worker. After that, I remember one time the way she's telling people, like, shut up, this. I'm like, no, somebody who has education cannot do that. What I'm saying, if I lie, God kill me. It's happening here in Canada, in Ontario. And then I say to myself, that's not good. And then after that, I remember they fell me in that program. They say I have to take that program. So what they have done is because the corruption is killing them. So they make up the problem. That way, I cannot get my kid. So I knew the psychological game earlier, how to protect myself. How? Because I learned from Bruce. I learned from all those people I named there. Not fighting. To me, when I watch the video, I watch a movie, I don't watch just people fighting, knocking somebody down. No, I watch how they think. You see. And then I remember after I went to different place they sent me. I remember I went to one place, the ladies from Ghana. She has her picture on the wall. They put the picture of Jesus, all this kind of stuff. Guys, people are using religion to kill the other people. Be careful. That lady was talking to me, this. At the same time, she's collecting my information, giving to the social worker. You see, you have to be careful. I'm gonna close from there. I'm gonna explain to you guys later on now. Stress management. Sometimes you may have, when a lot of things going on, you can have like depression, stress, lack of sleep, this. it can boost you to become really angry, but you can manage that. If you like music, put some music, a little bit, relax. If you want to go for a walk, try to go to bed on time, please. Drink a lot of water, it's good for you. Soft music, if you like music, it's going to help you a lot, okay? Try not to go to bed late all the time. Try not to, don't do that. I did, like, many years ago when I start, when I didn't have those problems. So you have to be careful, okay? So I'm going to explain to you guys more later on, okay? We come here. We have a different people who can help you. Professional, okay? We have school counselor. We have a college counselor. We have mental health counselor. We have substance abusive and behavior disorder counselor. We have it. We have the marriage and the family counselor. We have a clinical counseling and school psychologist. We got the child, family, and school social worker. We got the healthcare social worker. We got psychiatrist. Okay. To me, what I want to do, become like a college counselor, or if you want to register for school, you don't know what to do. To me, I want like academic advisor. I can do that. I have no problem with that. Teaching, I like what I'm doing so far. So college counselor, this is what I want to do. Marriage and family counselor, this is what I want to do. Child, family, and school social worker, this is what I want to do. It's easy for me to do it. So the other section, even a school counselor, yep, this one, I'm okay with this. I can do this. I don't have any problem. So for the interview, when you have a client, you need to get data, the information from them. So you have to listen to them. You have to question them. You have to give them time to respond to you, okay? So that's what I put here. Interviewing is the basic process used for gathering data, providing information and advice to a client, okay? So you're going to collect information by interviewing them, and then from there you're gonna get the information what need to be done. For example, let's say you beat your wife, or you guys are having a fight at work or in school. So people need to know what happened, what did you do, what went wrong. Let's say that you and your wife, you were fighting by mistake, you put the knife or the bottle of water and hit your child. People want to know what happened before that problem start. What did you, it's just like when you if you study computer, when you do the troubleshooting, you want to know when you turn your computer on, it's not working. You want to know before you turn your computer off, yesterday this computer was working, what happened? So same thing, it's a part of troubleshooting. Before you and your wife start arguing, what happened? Before you have an affair, what happened? What the reaction? What happened? What happened between you and that receptionist when you met her the first day? What did you do? What kind of contact? What kind of conversation you guys have? What lead you to have an affair with that receptionist or the other person? So by collecting information, you're going to know what kind of treatment you're going to provide them after, okay? So that's what I put here. Interviewer can find in many settings, including employment office, school, and hospital. Okay, so professional in many areas also use this skill. Okay, so in medicine, business, law, community development, library work, government office, okay. So coaching, yes, they also use it, okay. So, counseling, right? So, counseling is more intensive and personal process, okay? So, the counselor and the therapist interview to gain client information. When I say gain, it's like to get information, okay? So, counseling is more about listening to and understanding a client's life challenging and developing strategy for changing and grow, okay? We come here, that's what I also put here, okay? So, in counseling is more often associated with the professional fields of counseling, human relationship, okay? Clinic, counseling, and counseling, psychology, this one, pastor, counseling, okay, if you're a Christian, social work, okay, is also a part of the whole of medical, personal, and psychiatrists, okay? So, in human relation, it's also teach us how to handle the people. You have a wife, you have a girlfriend, you have a husband, you have a friend. So let's say you have a wife or your fiance. You guys need to talk. You know, when you have a vehicle, you drive your vehicle so fast, you do a lot of things very, very fast, you're going to damage that vehicle, right? So you need to go, you need to have the maintenance for that vehicle, right? Same thing with a relationship. You need to talk to your girlfriend or your wife. You need to have time to spend with your partner. You have to listen to your partner. You have to share the feeling. All these things are important, so important. You need them, okay? If the other problem we have in a relationship also is, if you are a Christian, let's say your wife is a Christian, believe in God, and the husband doesn't believe in God, you guys are going to have problems. Because one person understands well, the other one don't. Your wife understands that, no, with God, with this, it's going to help us. I cannot cheat on my husband because it's not good. I cannot cheat on my wife. It's not good. And then I have to do this for my family. By doing those kind of things, you guys are going to produce a healthy relationship, right? But let's say I'm a Christian. I believe in God. I believe I'm doing the right thing. My wife likes to drink, go to nightclub every weekend. She and I, it's not gonna work. It cannot work because she belongs in different society. I belong in different society. So when we when you decide to date, to marry somebody, you have to think carefully. Don't just go and date, and because this day people don't date. People just, you met her, you make love, after the next day you guys broke up, you see. That's how our society works in North America. You don't really date. Give yourself enough time to get to know the person, what kind of person she is, what kind of person you are. No, people just met today. The next day, they want to make love. After the love is done, bye-bye, you go to the next one. No. When the way I grew up and the way I'm being raised, no. You have to get to know the person. You start to get to know your friends after that. And then you guys start building the friendship and a little bit. And then everything's going to start later on, you know. But in Canada, life is different. In North America, life is different, right? So sometimes people involve in a relationship because of the low income. He doesn't make enough money. She make a lot of money. Or she make a lot of money. He doesn't make a lot of money. In some situation, you have no choice. You're involved in a relationship. It's not yours. You see, it's causing a lot of problems. So we have to be careful who you want to be with. Like in my case, when I look at the situation, I look like the woman I want to marry, I want to make sure that she believe in God. She finish high school. She have a college degree. Even though she has a master's degree or PhD, at least she have a college degree. She works. She's beautiful. Even if she's not beautiful, it's okay. She know how to take care of her body. She can listen to me. I can listen to her. We talk. That's kind of woman I want. That's good enough. But if I want to date somebody who go to nightclub, she goes party after party, that's not the kind of woman I want to know, because I don't belong to that society. That's not my lifestyle. You see, so we have to choose who you want to date, who you want to be. That's how it goes, right? Some people, they don't care. They see the girl, they just like it because she's hot, this girl is good looking, and then when they make love the next day, they look at, bye-bye. And she give you the finger, or you give her the finger, that's not good. You don't want that kind of lifestyle. That's why a lot of people having, you look at their kid behavior. Mm-mm. So we have to be careful who we want to date, okay? And then we come here. That's why I put for the psychotherapy, okay? So for you guys to get the note. Same thing I put here. Okay. And then the importance of attending session. You know, when you're teaching, you're helping somebody. Let's say that I'm gonna have interview with my client. She divorced, or their son is not doing well in school, or her husband have anger problem. So I have to create a session, how many classes that person need to attend. And from there, let's say the person, if the person has to be in a class for 6 months, 3 months, if he miss one class, it's okay, or two, it's okay. But if he complete all of them, he understand it, he never gonna repeat the same mistake again. No. Let's say that I met a girl. She's hot, beautiful, everything. She looks so hot. But she doesn't have a high school diploma. She doesn't work. She doesn't have a disability. Is that kind of girl I want to be with? No. But if you can provide her the right tool, you help her, she understand it, and she say, okay, I don't want this kind of lifestyle. Those kind of thing, you want to do this. Let's say, for example, you guys met together, okay? You guys met, and you start getting to know your girl. She doesn't have a high school diploma. She doesn't have this, this, this. And you guys talk, right? You cannot just say, she doesn't have this. I don't want her. No, it doesn't work like that. If you see, you say, okay, you don't want her. Why not you get your high school diploma? After your high school diploma, you go in college. If she say it's okay, that's good, let's do it. And she goes in college or high school. She get her high school diploma. After that, she start college. After college, she finish. Yes, you love her. You cared about her. That's why she decided to do that, right? So you guys have to have a conversation.